Hello and welcome to Forum Review. Florida's Gulf Coast has seen a massive 10-foot storm surge followed by an evacuation of 500 residents from the town of Stenachi. The town is just one of the many coastal communities of the Gulf Coast that have dealt with the severe impact of Hurricane Helene, a Category 4 storm with winds up to 140 miles per hour. The hurricane has now weakened to a tropical storm over the Carolinas with the maximum wind speed of 45 miles per hour. The cyclone is now to make a landfall near the mouth of Osceola River that has also seen the landfall of Hurricane Idalia last year. But what is basically the difference between a hurricane and a tropical storm? There is no fundamental difference. Hurricanes, typhoons and cyclones are all types of tropical cyclones named differently based on their location. Hurricanes form over the Atlantic Ocean and the East Pacific Ocean. Typhoons form in the Northwest Pacific Ocean. Cyclones form in the Bay of Bengal and the Arabian Sea. The different names signify regional differences but refer to the same meteorological phenomena of tropical cyclones. A storm surge occurs during a hurricane, making the seawater rise above the normal level. The surge produces winds that push the water into the shore, leading to massive floods. Storm surges depend on the intensity of cyclone and coastal bathymetry. When a cyclone is in deep ocean waters, the circulating winds pushes the ocean surface to create a vertically circulating column of water where the surge is barely visible. However, as the storm moves closer to the shore, the water, which is being pushed downwards by the wind, cannot move any lower. So the water forces itself from the sides towards the land, causing a storm surge wave. Although the low pressure also contributes to the surge, its influence is very small, around 5%. Whenever a cyclone moves near coastal areas, storm surges are the biggest and the most common threats to life and property. This phenomena is commonly found in low pressure systems, and the severity of storm surge waves depends on the tides, the shallowness of water in the area, and the angle at which the water is to the cyclone. Other factors that influence the intensity of the storm surge include the size and the strength of the storm, the atmospheric pressure, the bottom conditions near the shore, where a shallow and smooth ocean floor near the coast can dramatically enhance the speed and power of the storm surge, while a steep climb with a rough obstructive slope can slow down or even sometimes stop a storm surge. Other factors also include tidal waves, wherein a storm surge becomes more intense during high tides, where during the low tide, the intensity of the storm surge is significantly reduced. Sea waves also break into the beach and they may collect into the pools, eventually making it easier for the surge to overcome the friction of the beach and move further inland. The intensity of the hurricane is determined by the storm surge, and also it determines the amount of damage it can potentially cause. The most common way to measure a hurricane's strength is the Saffir-Simpson scale that assigns a category from 1 to 5 based on a storm's sustained wind speed at its center, with 5 being the strongest. This was it about the Hurricane Helene. For more such important and quick updates, make sure to follow, like, share, and subscribe. Thank you.